Phobia look like we hit bricks, how like we sell bricks. We don't sell shit, we just make hits. Yeah. Tryna keep it my composure, never sober, never choking, always smoking doji. Fuck them if they getting over, got a monkey, I caught me cause the kid the Cody's. I ain't changed, I stay the same and maintain it. Safe to say the kid getting older. Forever gang, I'm never switching over. Made a lane and niggas can't get over. I can't mess with rappers, they be bogus. Rather get a pack and keep it over. Big dripper, stand up in the ocean.
So we just landed in beautiful Dubai. We're gonna hang out with Mongrel, Econ Brothers, and we have a crazy week ahead, okay? At the end of the week, we have UFC, where Usman and Chimaev are gonna fight. We have Islam and Volkanovski. That's gonna be a very exciting fight. We have Yacht Day planned. We're gonna do all the cars, the whole Dubai experience, okay? I'm gonna take you guys with me. Excited for it? Let's go.
What do YouTubers in your niche make, like the ones that are very active?
Just Fortnite earnings alone, like competitive Fortnite. I have like 700k, like tournaments. Just
prize. You gotta be gone first.
Well, yeah, like first, second, third, whatever. The most I earn from one tournament, like 2 days, like 400k.
Did they offer you to like do a partnership with Fortnite?
No. That's actually sad. I asked so many times as well. Because so some people get their skin in game, they get like a percent of the revenue. And I asked them so many times.
I'm not gonna lie, I think 2 years ago you would look like a default character.
You wouldn't see a difference, bro.
That would have been the best thing. I always asked them as well and they never did it.
I'm just excited to see you spend
20k at the mall. I want a Rolls Royce Cullen. Those are so sick.
Bro, this guy in London?
Wants to live like a grandpa.
That's why we're going to the mall, because I actually need to change some of my drip. Some more flashy stuff.
I think I'm moving out of my house.
That's why I'm going to rent it out. And get an apartment in like central London. Because like, having 5 bedrooms to myself is too much. It's too big for just me. Like, I barely use any of the rooms.
What made you buy that?
The reason why I bought it was because I was looking at like that general area for like 6 months, yeah. Just over 6 months. I'm like, that was by far like the best house that's come up. Like I bought it for like just over one, and I think it's worth like 1.3 to 1.5. I feel like it was a good snipe, so I was like, fuck it, I'll just buy it.
Did you get a mortgage?
No,
just cash.
Yeah.
Why? Like why?
Bro, no interest in the mortgage, fuck that. I can just rent out and get infinite like money come in without any expenses. People think housing market will probably crash next 2 years, but whatever, in 10 years it will be back. It'll be above again. One of the main reasons I bought the house was because like I had like 80% in fiat. Like I didn't like it. Like all my money was in my bank, I wanted to put it somewhere else.
Bro, you made those dookie dash, you made 2 envelopes. How much did you make? 2.1, right?
Yeah.
Where are your parents from?
Like kind of near where my old place was.
Don't you want to retire them?
Well, I've asked them if they want to be retired. They'd say no. I've asked them like a couple times now. They always say no. Like then I think like if they was retired, I actually think they'd hate it. Because bro, like when I've been doing nothing all day, it's the worst thing ever. I'm good at badminton. Like I'll smoke Alex, bro.
You know where I'm from?
Bro,
tell me.
China, bro. You didn't see them people?
I'll bet with him. Like I'll smoke him.
How are you making money right now?
Bro, mainly just like random crypto shit that comes up. I've got like a lot in the bank, a lot in crypto. I still get like monthly income from just random shit. YouTube, Twitch, creator code.
Bro, I was an NPC
like back in October 2020 or whenever. When I was like at my full peak, like I'd average like 40k viewers on Twitch. Yeah. I remember in one of those months I streamed like 16 hours with 40k viewers average. Like it's the biggest NPC. No, like that the whole month, that's all I streamed, 16 hours. Back then I only cared about the competitive. Like, I didn't even really care about the money at all. I just wanted to be, like, the best player.
Were you the best Fortnite player?
Yeah.
The number one.
Yeah.
Ninja was pretty good, right?
In the start, bro, he was good.
Who was the most popular player?
Probably Ninja or Tfue. I got videos of me on YouTube from, like, 10 years ago. 11 years ago, like, me playing FIFA and shit. My squeaky voice.
Bro, you seem like such a... I think if I play against you, like a tryout, I told them as well, like if we would buy a PlayStation
I'll
here, bro.
I'll smoke you in any game, bro.
Any game. You know, it's not like I'm building something for money.
Bro, if I'm trying to move your position, okay, you have money, you have fame, you also have. Extra 100k is not gonna change anything in your life. I don't know what I would do, bro. You need a motivation outwards, like.
That's what I'm trying to find. Money can't be the motivation anymore.
For me, bro, I'm still money motivated. Every year,
I always say that, but like. I don't know, I fucking flew on the best flights, I stayed in the best hotel. It's like, it gets boring quick.
What my fires me up the most is my parents, bro. I just want to retire now. Just, bro, as soon as possible. Yeah, and the sooner the better.
Purple! It's a bit gay, but let's do it. It's Brava, so it compensates. Bro, it looks better in real life than it looks on the pictures.
Hey, this one also blacked out?
You're wrong.
Bro,
Okay, he doesn't know how to open the door. Bro, this one you can drive. This one is not that hard, is it? But obviously you have to be cautious.
You can drive anything.
No, I mean Lambo, bro. It's hard.
Bro, this is harder. 100%.
No, Lambo. 100%. Lambo.
This is so big.
No, bro, Lambo. You gotta be. This one, you're a big one on the road, but. Bro, on Lambo, you have to stop with every bump and everything.
Go. Like, this is so much easier to hit cars. Bro, I want to take this out tonight, like, late.
Bro, we got it in 3 days. What do you mean?
Dubai shit. Dubai whips. Different place. Different chips. ATL, this shit ludicrous. Oh, well, I like who that is. Dubai shit.
Bro, I told you I can't drive!
Bro, do you have a license, bro?
No, bro, I don't have a license. Disclaimer. Guys, we arrived at the final boss in this neighborhood. Look at this. The final boss. I don't know who lives here. Bro, this car is pretty easy to drive. My Golf in the Netherlands is harder to drive than this one, I swear. Look at this villa, this neighborhood, guys. This is motivation. I'm too broke. Gotta make more money. You see these houses? I live here. I already have a house.
We have a villa here, you know.
You live here?
Oh, we have a villa
for sale. In this neighborhood. How much is the price of our house here? The ones in the back. In USD. USD? 25. Yeah. Jump chase. Yeah, might be able to do that. Good day. So if you're not able to get pussy, you know with this car you can get it. Easy.
In Dubai, I'm smoking cookie in the hotel room. Cookie. Got me paranoid, thank you, sir. Let's go move.
What are we doing, bro? Buy something, please.
Lifestyle inflation. That's what we're going to do.
Perfect. Thank you.
Here we have it. Lucky green, I call it. If you know, you know.
In front of the store here?
But why you don't buy two, bro?
Just buying one, what the fuck?
We're gonna cut it out of the vlog. Cost me, bro. Bro, look at his wrist.
And he was with Future. Our Future king, man, the guy's like 6'4". Big guy. And even Drake is tall, but I was thinking, Future. And he comes to me, he's like, hey, man. And he's got a husky voice, you know? I wasn't ready. He's like, where is this brand from? I said, from Paris, from Bandung, you know, since 1906. Cool. We had tattoos, hoodie, and then they took pictures. The pictures we all off, like all our faces. He just takes what he's trying, and that's it. But that was the biggest celebrity I had. I think
Drake,
I had Daniel Craig in London as well.
Yeah.
James Bond and Mourinho is a guy. Is a good guy actually. And then we had Drake.
But you served all of them.
Yeah. If the last 3 years is crazy. Anthony Davis, we had to put 5 centimeters extra.
Wow, yeah, but it's a big guy, bro.
But it's like if a celebrity comes, bro, they shut down the whole store?
No, that was only in London. That was only for Drake, to be fair. The guy's massive. In London as well, he's got big, you know, energy. There's so many people around him, so everyone recognizes him quick. In Dubai, I mean, no, McGregor came, like, Mayweather, they come with like 10 security, so you see them, they come in, so you have to kind of, like, you know, everyone is like Star Trek.
Shaking.
They stop. And we, that's what we have upstairs, because it's more
quiet.
It's quieter, a bit more like, yeah.
Thanks so much, man. I'm
from Ran it up for miles. I don't get no help in stores. I'm really having style. Knew I was gonna be the man one day when I was a child.
Okay, let me explain. So I'm eating the chicken and the bones. I put it in my bag. George has a bag. Kyle has a bag. Bessam also has a bag to put in the bones. I'm looking at Alex. Alex only has chicken in a bucket. I'm saying, like, bro, where do you leave the bones? What do you say, Alex?
Bro, I eat everything, bro.
So it turns out the Chinese people also eat the bones. Driver, you want more?
No.
No, wallah.
No, wallah, man. Give me
more. What are we gonna do, Abba?
From the car.
Who's the fastest? We're gonna see who's the fastest.
Bro, I just hope like you don't crash.
Bro, during this whole trip,
I'm praying for
we have
the
to discuss who's the best driver.
I'm
we're
the
now
fastest.
Gonna see.
I'm
not making
it. It's the Iraqi against the Chinese.
Bro, he tried to speed me. Bro, he tried to speed me, right? And I just bumped him from the back and he stopped there. But let's see what's going
on. Alex is sweating, of course.
Yeah.
He bumped me off the truck.
Bro, I was doing my whole day, but the guy, he tried to speed me, right? I just bumped him in the back and he was stopping.
But this guy's still blocking me for 8 laps.
Yeah.
He's zigzagging in front of me.
He tried to
sleepy, right? I just go right, you go left, I go left.
I'm the old, I'm just flexing to the camera like this.
Kyle is number 20 and Alex number 21. What the fuck?
No, you have to check average.
No, bro.
What did you average?
You the best score, bro.
Really?
Yeah, bro.
So me number 5, number 7, 14 and 15.
Break game, break game.
Pop out. What's up? We making money in quarantine. Dirt in my stick and my wood clean. Is it Blue Benjamin's vaccine? Need to bounce back now on taxing. Fuck up the trap, we go tag team.
How much
did
you win?
74. He's like 68.
No, I'm 72.
Bro, you're 80. I haven't eaten in 5 days.
Bro, we need to get a scale.
Bro, let's get a skill.
Then tomorrow will we win?
Yeah, you're lean, that's the thing.
Of course I'm lean, but I gotta be, but I have a big dick, you know.
Bro, what is the highest paid game
to play if you wanna become an esports player?
Probably League of Legends.
League of Legends?
But just winning tournaments or just salary from the teams?
Probably both. I mean, like, in the past, Fortnite was the best for tournaments. Like I said, like, the guy won World Cup, 3 million in one day. When I was in World Cup, I'd done like 450k in 2 days.
450k because you were first place, right?
No. I was like, bro, 6th and 13th.
Really? What was the first place get?
3 million.
3 million prize money. What the fuck? Isn't high pressure to game there?
Nah, no pressure. I don't feel pressure.
How does your deal with FaZe look? You get salary or?
If you're a pro player, you get salary.
Is there no incentive if you do better, if you've gone bigger?
There is. Like, if you grow your socials, if you do well in tournaments, you can ask for a higher salary.
Yeah.
How do they make money? Like, basically, in general?
It's kind of tough for esports orgs to make money, actually. Like, it's quite hard, but like, if you do it right, it's definitely doable. Because like, they're sponsored by so many big companies. Like, Porsche is like a sponsor of FaZe.
Yeah.
Like, all the keyboards, chairs.
Does FIFA pay?
No, FIFA's really bad.
The pack openings.
Pack opening,
it was just gambling, like literally just gambling on stake, yeah. But then on like, okay, pack openings.
Like, it's so fun.
I used to buy these FIFA coins.
Yeah,
I used to dropship those, you know? Mm. Like, friends, they wanted to buy the coins. Like, bro, I can give you 100k for 10 euro,
but
then I buy it for 1 euro 50.
We bought the wrong coins back then, man. You don't have to be a good gamer to get paid, right, actually?
Like, if you're on a team, yeah. But like, if you're just making content.
Do you think you get famous because you were the best? Yeah. Like, the best gamer, or just because you were the personality?
Both. Because like, bro, back then I was screaming so much.
You know, actual speed is doing awesome.
Similar, but yeah. Like, not as far.
Let's go! Yes! Thank God!
Let's
I told you you'd win, bro! I told you you'd win!
But like, also being good at the game was like a big thing as well.
You always like did the head shot and also the keyboard also, right?
So I'm saying I'll beat you at any game, any sport.
Bro, you think this is a sport? Just click on your computer?
Yeah. Reaction time, G.
How did they find you?
I actually got pulled out for my team.
There's like a player that's bought from the computer.
Like that, yeah.
How much did they pay for you, right?
Undisclosed, G.
Six figures?
Undisclosed. I'm not Mbappe though, like, what?
How do you get attraction from zero to, for example, if someone wants to start streaming, you know, and they go live, nobody's watching them.
Yeah.
How do they climb on the levels?
I've always said it since the start, like, I think the best way to, like, grow your socials or stuff is just to be the best player again. Because, like, if you're the best player and you're always getting, like, first, second, and leaderboard, people always see your name, they want to look you up. Obviously, some of it is luck, but like, if you're the best player in a popular game, like, you always get traction.
Yeah,
because like, everyone wants to see you play. So that's what I say to people, like, if they want like the way to grow your stuff, the most likely way, highest probability, if you're the best player. 100%.
So if I would be a beginner, I would want to reach what you have reached, your levels, I would just grind it out in a game, be the best.
100%. If you're the best at a game, I think that's like the most efficient one. Highest probability. Because with content creation, like, you can be like the funniest guy ever, but if not enough people know your name, it's so hard to grow, you know? But, like, if you're the best player in the game, people see your name, leaderboard, they want to come look you up, you know?
Yeah, how much do you think it's personality going to play?
I think, like, if you're very good at a game, plus your personality, it's like the best combo. Like, just
yourself.
Making funny jokes, yeah, being yourself. Like, don't try and force something. So, like, when I was a kid, bro, I was just like, smashing shit, like.
If you're an influencer, let's say your main objective is getting views and getting attention, what do you think is the best business model to make money? Start your own company, sponsors, ad revenue?
I think if you've got like a lot of faces on you, then probably start a company like that. They're at like, what, $1 billion valuation right now. It's like impossible to make $1 billion on YouTube, you know? You have to start like a business. So if you've got lots of eyes on you, you make a product and it's good.
Logan Paul didn't start selling such a beverage until he was that big.
I think he made like 500k one day.
Do you think about starting your own product?
Yeah. That's the thing, like, I would never want to commit to something where, like, I do it for like 3 months and I'm like, nah, this isn't it. So, like, making a product is a big thing. Like, it has to be something I want to put years into, you know?
But how would you, if you want to start a physical product like that? For example, Logan Paul case, they have this, they only have a small percentage in Prime, right? They have a business guy, already an established beverage company, which they just white label the product, and then now they have a brand, right?
Yeah.
And if you would start a product, would you also do the business side, or you just do the marketing?
I need like a mentor, 100%. So I have too little experience in the business world. I think it's too much to take on to do the promotion and the business.
Yeah.
It's too much.
Fame or money?
If I had to choose, probably money. It's kind of cool, like being fully anonymous.
Bro, if you are famous and broke,
how can you be
famous and broke? Yeah. Like then you're stupid.
Bro, yeah.
Which is like the highest quality.
I think like maybe streaming. Bro.
Twitch.
Yeah, because when you're streaming and you have the chat, you're talking with the viewers live, you know? Like you're interacting. On YouTube, obviously, it's a video, blah, 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 but stream, you're live interacting with the viewers. I think, like, if you build, like I have, like, Twitch for years and years, that's, like, the strongest connection we can get, 100%.
If you would start from the start right now, how would you tackle this right now, at this moment of time?
Like, if I had nothing.
Yeah, if I had nothing.
I'd just be the best in the game and stream. Like, I have no idea where I actually want to permanently live in 10 years. And I've traveled to, like, 10 countries now, I still don't know. But every country's, like, got a different good thing about it. Like, it's hard. I don't know. I genuinely have no idea where I'm going to live in 10 years.
I have thought about that question a lot as well. But then I concluded, I just don't want to be at one place for long.
Yeah, I just want to travel.
Exactly. Because every country has its pros and its cons. Let's just live. I live in Bali, bro. You ever been to Bali? We could go to Bali one time and we're going to show you the Bali experience so you never come back. Only digital nomads go.
Yeah.
The people you are with is the most important. I can hang out with you guys everywhere. Yeah. We'll have fun everywhere.
I'm going to go to the toilet quick.
Film it, toilet.
You want to see the primal growl?
Let's go golfing!
Let's go golfing!
Okay, you are getting better actually, you are.
Show us how it's done, bro.
I'll show you how it's done. Usually Alex has like one or two good shots an evening, so you just have to keep filming the whole time and you'll eventually get one shot. Watch it.
Hey. 75, we're going down. You show us how it's done. Yeah. Hey.
Like a golf goes like this, but you do too much this, right? You start a little like this then, and then it automatically goes straight.
If you hit it, don't go up while you hit it, don't do this.
Stay exact same position.
Hey.
What am I saying?
What am I saying?
What the hell?
I said to you lower, bro.
For golf coaching and eco coaching, go to Alex.
Everything you need.
What am I saying?
Of course, any coaching.
Did I show the Airbnb already?
Not yet, bro.
Bro, look at this house. We're in the Palm Jumeirah, Dubai.
I mean, look at this house. Go inside. Maybe you have some ping pong tables. Some room to chill. We have a kitchen. Kitchen not so special. Here we have the living room.
To be honest, the interior isn't the best. If I would own this house, I would completely renovate this house. But we have Econ Brothers here. I don't know what they're doing, chilling. We have Kyle's cameraman. The man himself, me, bro. Well, that's on the outside. The outside is better than the inside. Some room to chill. Some grass, fake grass. And we're on private beach. I mean, look at it. Every day when you wake up, you can just do a walk around straight in the beach. Do some yoga, do some stretching, go into the pool, training. Look at all these houses in here, bro. I mean, obviously we rented this Airbnb, but I mean, manifesting. One day we'll own one.
He says he can do more push-ups than I can. I don't believe so, bro. A real push-up, huh? Stretch.
How many things I got?
You tell me, bro. Oh, legit push-ups, not fake push-ups.
Okay, he's getting tired.
Push, come on. Easy.
40.
40?
Yeah.
Okay, bro, 40. Nice.
You go.
I told you before, there are only three things guaranteed in this life. One is death, two are taxes, third I'll do more push-ups tonight. There you go.
They don't know me, son.
24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 34, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41,
42,
43, 44.
All the
push-ups. 4.
Alright, you guys judge who push up the bell.
We're judging quality, bro.
Done.
Easy. What are you doing? I'll send my energy, bro.
0.01.
So what do you want to bet you next?
No real money.
Badminton. That I'll actually bet you real money on badminton.
I'll do pull-ups.
How many can you do?
How many can you do?
Like 10?
I'll just do more than you do.
Bro, you're so much lighter than me. You're no, there's no way you're 73.
I'm 73, 74. Literally. How is your weight?
74.
Well, look at my thing, bro.
I'm bonking. I've got belly now.
Same way.
The man them too inconsiderate, 5-star hotel smoking cigarette, mixing codeine up with a Finnegan. She got thick but she wanna get Finnegan.
So he wanted to rent a yacht for a day. I contacted this rental company, but he said okay, let's come around and check out all the yachts. I think he thinks we're gonna buy a yacht or something, but let's just check out all the yachts. Maybe we'll buy one.
Take a look at these diamonds, wrong as a life is squinting, can't just stare.
It doesn't like feel like it's gonna look like this inside.
Dang! There's a hotel in here, bro. How much was this one?
$11 million.
Bro, I feel like for this is a good price.
This is the life I want to live. One day, guys.
Give me some time, we're going to live this life.
I think it's worth for this price. Depreciates a little bit. I mean, yeah. You have it for pleasure. I mean, life is great.
Yes, exactly.
Bro, I got motivated.
Yeah.
I'm not rich enough to buy this yet. I'm going to make more money. But it gives me, of course, materialistic stuff. They don't make you happy and stuff. But still, I'm rather on the yacht in here than in my hometown in the Netherlands, in the cold, grumpy weather.
Well, for me it was weird seeing the kids on the yacht.
Yeah, but fucking they have like a child a birthday party on there, bro.
They're like 11, 12, 13 year olds, you know?
Back in the days when we just went to McDonald's. They invite everyone get a happy meal, you know?
What is it exactly, which do you rent out yachts as a middleman?
My main business is to find private yacht owners and to convince them to charter them out.
You share the fee with them, right?
Yeah, they pay like a commission on the rate.
Is it lucrative, renting out yachts?
Oh, it is.
What is the busiest period?
It starts now.
These yacht owners, what do they do for a living? Most of them.
With most of them, I don't really know. Some are big in crypto.
But are these like foreigners or are these Dubai?
Many foreigners, yes. They brought their yachts from Europe to Dubai.
Bro, I only lost money with crypto.
Me too.
The Benetti, how much can you buy it for?
He's asking 19 million dirhams.
Is it a good investment just to buy and just rent it out completely? Or you have to, like for leisure, use it on your own and then it's good extra to rent it out?
There are two options. There are owners with big yachts that only charter to make back the money that they spend on the yacht.
Is it similar to a private jet business?
It's the same, yes. You just give it for charters whenever you need it, you take it out.
I just put 9 gal in a Sprinter. 100 eaters, it won't fit in one SUV. No. Somebody rescue me, I got too many when I got. They could last me the next 2 weeks. Alright. That send that address through me. SUV, the outside white, the inside brown like Mike and Jack. More time and build a line and trap. Spend like I don't even like my
stuff. What do people need to sell right now?
Sell something with a good margin, you know? And also just keep it simple, you know? You don't need some magic product or magic gadget that people never used before but they need to buy it now. You can just sell some basic stuff that people always already are buying. So now they just buy it from you if your creative is good, if your offer is good. It's really simple, you know? Just keep the product simple and focus more on getting better with marketing than so much trying to invent with a new product. I do eco mostly, you know? That's what I make most of my money. I do it together with my brother also. And yeah, we mainly run eco stores in Europe. We have a good team that basically has automated every part of the business. So think about product research, think about launching the campaigns, staying the campaigns, managing all the stores, you know, customer servers, dealing with disputes. Together with my brother, like, we automate those businesses, and able to travel, able to, you know, live a good life. Retired our parents, you know, it's the greatest achievement that we've done. It was hard to make money and become profitable with income, but once you understand the tricks and the ways to get a good conversion, it becomes a really easy game and fast to scale, you know. So then you hire more and more people, you launch more countries, you launch more products, and then you can just increase your business and make more money.
I'm not prepared enough right now for World War. If you read Ray Dalio's book, I mean, he's talking about these long-term cycles, right? And you see, okay, every 80 to 100 years as this long-term cycle just breaks. Last cycle was ending was since World War II, 1945. Then the world order changed again. USA got the most gold, they got the world power. Now we are approaching, they call it the fourth turning as well in some phases, or the just the last phase of this cycle. We're entering the 80 year again, okay? It has to be restructured. Before 1945, we had the UK, which was the world power, right? Before UK had the world power, we had the Netherlands, which was the golden age, that the world power. But it doesn't mean that a lot of people, when they read that book, think that, okay, this power, this country will just vanish, right? But it's not like the US dollar will vanish, I think. I think the US will just stay there, but won't be the dominant power anymore. As you see right now, I mean, USA and China are both similar level. Some of them have pros, some of them have cons. But it's almost inevitable that usually when there's a cat in the corner, right, it's gonna make weird jumps. They won't just fall down easily without a war or anything, fighting back. US is just losing on so many sides, right? I think if we were world war right now, I'm not prepared enough.
I think nobody is.
You don't have enough gold, you don't have, I don't know, currencies which are, which you could use. Once the war breaks out, you're too late, right? Because everyone wants to get their capital outside of the country. When in doubt, get out. Because once the time comes, everyone wants to get their capital out, right? They're gonna put restrictions, why? So you cannot put your capital out anymore. So the capital stays in the country. So you can, for example, your bank freezes. There's no way to transfer your money anywhere. How easy you can be fucked? For example, Russia right now, right? They had a war, but a lot of people, oligarchs, Russian billionaires, anywhere in the world, right? All these sanctions, people in UK, London, bank accounts just frozen just because they were Russian. But I have nothing to do with the war, right? I'm not saying it's going to happen with Netherlands or UK, but still, right? COVID, who the fuck expects COVID?
The only thing you can do now is make as much.
Yeah, as much as possible, and then you have to diversify, I think, yes. Currencies, value assets, we're talking before, right? Security.
Passports.
Also, yeah, passports, so you're not fucked in one country. I think it's gonna happen. It has to be too much tension. If you really just objectively think about it, we are 20, around 20 right now, let's say we live to 100. You really think next 80 years is just gonna be peace?
We so were all happened. Born in peace. We exactly. See the standard as peace, yeah. But it hasn't been like yeah. This. And I think COVID was a major shock for the people because they never experienced such measures.
Yeah, I think we're too young.
We are 20, 2000s.
But we don't have a choice. If war's coming in 3 years, what do you want to say?
I'm too young. I know, no, of course. But I'm just saying, like, bro, it's just experience. But when you listen to Mark Joyner speak, like, you can just tell he's so experienced. I'm 19, bro. You're 20. Like,
yeah. Only thing we can do right now, the only question I'm still thinking about, okay, how do we prepare if such a thing happens?
You know what's dangerous as well is making, like, lots of money young and thinking, like, you're the shit.
Yeah.
But, like, you're not. Like, you really know nothing.
Yo, Nick, pass, make it slack. I've been on the road, I'm gone. Private jet for me and the Rosie. Extra Renzo, pick up clothes. I made a fence and hit my hose up. Down on what I'm on, I'm on.
Bro, you see, now it's proven who's the worst driver.
No, I'm driving the best.
Always excuse
me. We got on two wheels on the hill, bro.
Obviously.
Cashed out with all blue hunters. I see through that cap, shit, cut it out. Way too young and turned to settle down. I build niggas up, they let me down.
We're going back to Cagao. Kyle wants to buy something.
How much do you think it costs to, like, have a room here, you know?
Oh, no, that's expensive, bro. Middle of nowhere.
Hello.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Hi. If you want to sell something to someone who doesn't like diamonds, then obviously you're going to lose. You're adding value to already high-value piece.
So, like, you have to, like,
for instance, this is what we've done. This is what we call a custom piece. So with this, it's the original base watch. It's steel, right? And then we've done all the diamonds on it. Change the dial. Whereas this.
So when I first moved here, I had to do that for the first
is what we call a full custom.
My dad doesn't know.
You've got the original 8 pin movement inside, but everything around it. So you've got bracelet, case, bezel, everything is what we've built. But everything else that we've built. With this, you get the original box of papers. With this, you don't get the papers, you get
way too much money.
But you get the warranty from us. This is something that we've built. We've taken the movement from an original piece. And then we've built the whole thing around it.
Because a lot of, like, watch experts, they are haters on diamonds. Like, I have friends which are, like, into watches, and I say I want to buy a diamond one, they immediately cringe and say, always
buy one. It depends, right? Because it depends what you like, basically. You're training a watch into a piece of jewelry. So if it's because you're interested in watches as an investment, then no, you shouldn't put diamonds on.
We're still, yo, we like the diamonds.
Oh, yeah, I love it.
Diamonds. She's calling my phone like I'm locked up nonstop. From the plane to the fucking helicopter.
How did you actually roll into this?
This is by accident. So, like, I had a business in the UK. I was selling, like, alcohol online, and I also had, like, a bit of property and stuff. And then I was, like, making money but doing okay. And then I sold my alcohol business, but, like, not for, like, crazy money. Just, like, got out of it and had, like, money to live off for a bit. So I moved here, had some friends, and I literally partied for a year. And then I was like, I need to do something. I need to make money. And I was living off, like, I don't know, $300-$400 a week. I had this plain Cartier that I was talking about earlier, and I decided, can I put diamonds on it? And I spoke to a guy, and he recommended somebody. And, like, I picked up the watch, and, like, within 3 days, like, all of the stones have fallen off, like half the wall. watch. Like, the work was so bad, and I was like, there's got to be a way to do this better. Like, there's companies in the US and UK doing it. Labor here is doable, there's jewelry, there's diamonds. So I just, like, I set my own up. So I started with like 15 grand sterling, two watches, put diamonds on it, and then just tried advertising it. Started like social media page 8-9 years ago, the Kago one. I used to do like pictures with like the swimming pool behind, like near where I lived and whatever. Grinding. And then like I got one big client in the US. He's like an ex-skateboarder, and he bought a watch to me, and my...
Tony Hawk.
Not as big, like a Rob Dyrdek. He does like a short interview called Ridiculousness. And like he bought the first watch, not the first watch, but like the first big piece for me. Sent the watch, he's like, thank you very much. Like, I'll do a post for you. He had like 4 million followers at the time. 2 weeks go by, nothing. 3 weeks go by. Third week, I'm sat at home on my sofa. My phone's just ping, 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 ping. And he did like, he sang it, he like did a video singing happy birthday to himself and tagged my company for free. 4 million followers. And instantly validated my business overnight. And everyone was like, oh, okay, cool. Like, they're legit. So, and then anyone that went to come to buy from us, they're like, oh, like, you don't have an office, I don't know you. I'm like, this guy in Hollywood's buying from us. Here's the proof. And it like, it helped me close so much business because it validated the social profile. Because watches is trust. It's like, if you have somebody who cuts your hair, you have the guy who cuts your hair, you trust him. You go and see him, you're like, you can relax. When you go to a new guy, you're like,
stress.
Like, what's this guy doing to my hair? Or like, you know, if you go to a surgeon or whatever, you want to make sure the surgeon's the best. Hi, Rico. Perfect.
It's perfect.
Don't go tighter than that.
Again, bro.
Thank you so much. Pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, you too.
Cool.
Look at him flesh.
I feel like I'm just making infinite connections in Dubai, bro.
I think if you're here for a couple months, you know everyone.
Hey, shorty with the long text, I don't talk. Shorty with the long legs, she don't walk. Yeah, last year I kept it on the tuck. Hey, 2020, I came to fuck it up. Yeah.
Bro, being in Dubai motivates me as fuck. Always when I'm here, I just get this fire which already in me just gets fired up even more and more. From where I'm from the Netherlands myself, and being in Dubai, it's just such more higher frequencies. People think bigger. Being in this Airbnb in here, obviously we rented this Airbnb, but still motivates me as fuck to think bigger, that I have to make more money, level up my mindset, and just overall go level up as a person. From where I'm from in the Netherlands, bro, it's so small thinking. It's cold always, it's rainy, everyone is grumpy. I mean, look at all these houses in these neighborhoods, bro. Bro, all these guys, they're not doing dropshipping, okay? They're not affording a $25 million home in here by doing dropshipping or by doing some internet hustling. Okay, of course, it's great for your first bag. If you want to make your first $1 million, go do dropshipping, go do e-commerce, go do something which makes your internet hustle. But I'm thinking, okay, I've made the bag with e-commerce. I became a millionaire with e-commerce myself. But if I want to afford a house like this on the Palm in Dubai, sheikhs living on your fucking neighborhood. We're driving here, literally there are Bugatti Chirons just standing there. I saw like the number 5 license plate like a couple of houses further. Bro, that fucking number 5 license plate only costed 33 million dirham. I just looked it up. And what you have to realize, all these homeowners in here, bro, they all have the same 24 hours as you do. Even Elon Musk or any big entrepreneur you're looking up to. The only difference is that they use their 24 hours better than you do, okay? What you have to realize, these people are not aliens. And that's one of the biggest realizations I also got this year. I was going to all these masterminds, meeting these big entrepreneurs who have, in my eyes, made it back then. I looked at them and I'm obviously positively comparing myself to them, not in a negative way, but just purely, what is the difference between me and them? And what I'm seeing and what I'm realizing is that these people are humans too. I mean, they didn't come from fucking planet Mars to here. Do you think that all these people who own these homes, that they are mindlessly scrolling on TikTok and just consuming content? Nah, bro, it's all mental masturbation if you don't take action of whatever you're looking at right now, okay? If this video motivates you, you should immediately make a plan and take action on it. And having this realization, I'm just thinking, if they can do it, why can I?
La la, yeah. La la, wait till I give my money right. Oh. I had a dream I could buy my way to heaven. When I awoke, I spent that on a necklace. Oh. I told God I'd be back.
What are you doing, dude? You're on a yacht and you
no,
just
I'm
play chess.
On a yacht.
It's the same as playing ping pong the whole time. Just quit with it.
Yeah,
even Mitchell's laughing. He can't hold the camera anymore.
Well, let's just spar. Much more exciting than this. Until death, until submission, someone touch. Or knockout.
This one was right, 60 million dirham, right?
That's 4 million euros.
And I think you buy it just a second hand, bro. I'd be able to do that. And you can charter it for Formula 1 and everything, bro.
Bro, you can at least like 50 people with this, bro. At least.
Every time I do a party where there's events, basically. Yeah.
Small, I can't see it.
Boom! Go fast, bro. The background's fading too fast.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, go. I need solo.
Do the bridge. Do the bridge.
I feel the pressure under more scrutiny, and what I do, act more stupidly. Bought more jewelry, more Louis V. My mama couldn't get through to me.
the drama, people suing me.
So I think the gap between rich people and poor people are gonna be bigger and bigger, okay? It's gonna be half yachts and half not. Obviously we rented this yacht, but I mean, I'll own one day, okay? It's gonna be a matter of time before I own one. I mean, look at this yacht, look at this life.
So you're 20 years old, I'm 23. Being on a yacht in Dubai, at this age, not many people are able to do it.
If you think about it, it's pretty damn crazy.
It is crazy, but it also shows like it is possible. I mean, we worked hard, but at the same time, it doesn't matter if you're like 16, 17 or 18 years old. You can already start, you know. You don't need to wait until you're an adult to start making money. I know people in Dubai, 15, 16 year olds, that are making six figures a month. Just online, just behind their laptop, doing some stuff on their phone. Not even crypto, you know. There's many digital businesses to create cash flow and income.
Exactly. And it's like, bro, we are not that special. I mean, we are committed. We all work for yachts, but we're not smarter than the rest.
We have people that are 16, also on yachts in Dubai. And
bro,
they also
I
come
feel
from
old
nothing.
Here. I mean, look at Calvo, what he's achieved this fucking age. He just turned 19. Yeah. He's on a yacht in Dubai here flexing, buying watches. Yeah. What the fuck? Please think about it. But obviously, we don't compare ourselves to our people, normal people from age, to say it like that, obviously with all the respect. But usual people, bro, still in school.
I think it's just the earlier you start, the farther you will go, you know, because you need to put time into the grind and focus as much as possible on cash flow. Don't start, like if you have 2K, don't start with crypto and think crypto is gonna go to, how much do you need to, if you go 10x from 2K, you go to 20K.
Exactly.
It's not a big.
You're still broke.
You're still broke, even with 20K. And let's say you make 100x, you go from 2K to 200K, it's also not that. You can't do much with 200k, let's say, if you want to live a good life. So I would focus as much as possible on just cash flow businesses.
Yeah.
E-com, brands, dropshipping, providing services, you know, high-ticket services.
Yeah. Probably all of the viewers watching, they're going to be young guys or young people, bro, and they're going to be inspired looking at this, seeing this yacht, all the materialistic stuff, right? The supercars, the watches. I think, bro, I want to live that life too, but I want to give something for the viewers. Bro, this materialistic life is not what you should strive for, okay? You get used to this shit. Obviously, we're not flying private jets yet, but I'm 100% sure when we're going to fly private jets or own this yacht, you'll get used to it, okay? And that's what I'm going to realize, okay, this materialistic stuff is not where I worked for, okay? It's going to be, obviously, the journey should be the prize. That's what I'm going to think about.
And also just having the freedom. It's not so much about the car, but it's about the freedom that you have. You can do whatever you want, whenever you want, and nobody's saying to you, like, okay, you have to abide by this or listen to this.
We could be on this yacht every day, just chilling, charter yacht, go to jet skis, but believe me, we have the possibility to do that every day, but we still choose to grind every day, okay? Work and still hustle.
Because we're not there yet.
Exactly, exactly.
I mean, we always strive to grow and progress in something.
That's what you see a lot of successful people here as well, bro. They just get complacent, okay? They think I made it, bro. Here I ain't shit, I'm broken here.
A lot of people, they want to get rich or they want freedom, they hate their job. A lot of people that are stuck in routines, they don't love it. At the same time, if you want to get rich, there won't be any magic moment. There won't be any moment where you think like, oh, suddenly I get a big bag out of the sky, or suddenly this guy out of nowhere he comes and he helps me and now I have this opportunity and I can become rich. It doesn't work this way. And the same thing for you, like if you look back at your journey, there wasn't a single point where you'd say like, okay, it came out of luck. It was all like small steps. You started with a brand, you do some marketing, you know, you see it's not profitable. People quit at this point, you know. You kept going. First day you make profit, then you start scaling, you go to new countries, and slowly by slowly you start earning more and more money until you become at the point where you look back and think, okay, what the fuck?
They call you an overnight success.
Overnight success, but you've been putting in work for a couple of years and it all adds up. Like small steps, they do add up. The thing is, you don't see it in the short term. You can't expect to have big success in your first month or 2 months.
What would you say for the viewers watching, where like, let's say I'm between the age of 17 and 20, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
I see us living this life in yacht on Dubai. What do you say to that guy or girl?
I would say it's possible. Know that nobody's going to do it for you, you know? Even if you're in a bad situation, I have a lot of DMs where people say like, yeah, I'm depressed, my mother is sick, I'm alone, it's not working out for me. I said like, bro, it's gonna be hard, you know, like nobody said it was easy, but it's worth it if you keep going. And like, what's the alternative, you know? What's the alternative? If you say, I don't have time for a business, then for what do you have time? Your study isn't going to give you the things you want.
Exactly.
Like maybe you study for 4 or 5 years and then you can get a job where you earn 3K, take taxes off of it, you get like 2K net. Like what can you do with 2K? You know, prices are going up. Maybe go on a vacation once a year, you know, if you pull all the money with your girlfriend, whatever. But it's gonna be difficult, you know, like realize there is no alternative. If there was an alternative where you could make a lot of money without any risks, without any struggles, you can consider it, but there is not. You have to struggle.
We were talking about yesterday, right? I mean, how can you be the average guy nowadays? Obviously you start as average or below average, but how can you just
be average in life, bro. You can't get any girls. You're competing with guys who have everything, bro.
Yeah, yeah. But you know what's the thing? Because like I'm still a lot of times in my regular old time, you know, old town, and see these people. I think a lot of them, they want it, but they are just scared. You know, it's like a little coward. People don't want to take risk. I'm like, why, bro? What do you have to risk? Especially if you're just starting out. Like, you have nothing to lose. Like, what can you lose? Same. Only thing you can lose is time. But I mean, you have to trade your time for something. You know, either for a business where you can, there's no like earning cap, or you trade it for a boss, or you say, I have an internship, I have to spend all this. Bro, fuck your internship, fuck your work, fuck your study, because you won't be getting anything out of it.
Literally, that's what I realized in the years that I've been in business. Everything what we do in business, bro, it's very simple, but it's hard. Okay, the concept itself is very simple. Okay, e-com, you buy a product from China, you ship it here, and then you ship it to the customer, you do some marketing online, done. But it's gonna be hard, okay? But it's gonna be long nights, early mornings, blood, sweat, and tears, but the concept itself is very simple, right? And it's like you say, bro, what is the alternative? Bro, you're gonna live in the rat race forever? What the fuck? Work a job, minimum wage, then pay off your live the right to pay off your mortgage? Yeah.
Twin bitches hopping off a jet ski.
Yeah!
Twin bitches
hopping off a jet ski.
Doesn't matter where we are, we still at KFC.
Bro, they bring it like with the speedboat, you know? Just you need to pay, that's the only thing. If you can pay, everything gets fixed in Dubai.
Not electric, this shit gassed up, can you catch it? The Virgil Jetski 10150, check the leverage.
So we just went to Kagao, checked out the diamond watches. Bro, I fell in love with the diamond Rolex. But to be honest, it's a waste of money. So we're going to the UFC right now in Abu Dhabi. It's gonna be sick. If I win this bet, then I'm gonna buy it.
150, check the leverage. Got two twins, they top tier, that's my favorite fetish. Deep in the throat till she tear, I'm a favorite beverage. Ran out of time, made 10 APs, man, I can't retire. Been on the road collecting rubber bands to match a tire.
So it's gonna be fight night. I got my money on Usman Islam. I really wanna buy a diamond watch. But let's see what all the hype is all about.
We came across a student of ours.
Tell them about your experience from the coaches.
That's amazing, man. Yeah, it's been great. It was just perfect, man. Really appreciate this guy, really.
Bro, it's one of my best students. He's gonna be a killer. Watch him, he's gonna crush it. 100K day soon.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. Oh, man,
during the fight, no worries.
We're making money, next time we'll get it.
What's up guys, that was it for the first YouTube video. You know, if we do the first YouTube video, we have to start with a fucking banger, okay? Make sure you like, subscribe, comment in this video what you want to see in the next video. More entertainment, more lifestyle. If you want folks like this or you want more value, just let me know down in the comments. And remember, we're not here to take part, we're here to take over.
It's mad cause I made it. New whip looking like a spaceship. You're looking like you're stuck inside the matrix. I could teach you how to hustle, how to save it. When the money talks, I can translate it.
Hey, GG's bro.